Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
ChiIL Mama is here today with Jessica, and she is the publicist for Cirque du Soleil's Quidam. Yeah. And they're going to be here in February from the 8th through the 12th.
That's correct. We'll be just in the suburb in the Hoffman Estates at the Cirque Center, and we'll be here for 8 performances only. So it's a short engagement this time. Make sure you don't miss it.
Absolutely. Now, this is a new thing. I know you were here with Quidam a number of years back in the Big Top in a little bit smaller space. Now you're doing an arena show.
We do. It's quite new in the Cirque world. A few years ago, we've started. The first show was Alegria, which also came to Chicago first and then to Hoffman Estates under the arena format. So what we do is some of our classic shows like Quidam, like Alegria, like Giralion and Saltimbanco, have toured around the world already and seen all the big cities that usually are visited by the Big Top one, twice, sometimes even 3 times. So at one point, there's so many cities in the world that we can go to at the Big Top. And the shows are still beautiful, relevant, and they still speak to people. So we can't just retire the shows. So what we do is we kind of give them a second life under the arena format. So we do an artistic and technical restaging of the show to adapt to the venue and also to give it a nice fresh look. And then what we do is we set up in venues, but we don't use the arena as big as the arena is. What we do is we'll cut about a third out, we'll put a black pipe and drape, and that becomes our backstage area, so where the artists do their warm-up, the trainings, where we have all the props and all the road cases for the show. And then in front of that black curtain, then the stage will come all the way on the floor. We'll have a few rows on the floor, and after that the seating will be, it replicates pretty much what we used to have under the Big Top. So it's like around the stage like this, and every seat is a great seat. So
it's still intimate.
It's still pretty intimate for, a lot of people are quite surprised when they enter the arena and they see how we transform it and how it's reminiscent of the Big Top. We also have some really nice string lights that come down, and the way the lighting is made also just makes you focus on the action and on what you see on stage.
Excellent. Now, we've seen a number of Cirque shows. We just saw Ovo come through town last.
Yeah.
What would you recommend? What's different about this one?
Well, since you guys are used to it and you've seen several Cirque shows, you know that every Cirque show is a complete departure from one another. It's got a different storyline, a different live band playing the music, different costumes, makeup. I think the strength of Quidam is 2 things. One of them being that it's a very human-based show. So you'll have a lot of feelings and a lot of familiar situations, and you can relate to the characters. All the characters are quite eccentric, but they are human-based. So they're not, you know, inspired by bugs, a bit like Ovo or like Varikai, that are like very fantastical creatures. We're very human-based, as I said, and we follow the story of a little girl, and people can relate to many of the characters, either Zoe, the little girl, the mom, the dad, or one of the funky characters that she's going to meet throughout the show. And also, I think the show, one of its strengths is that it is one of Cirque du Soleil's classic shows. It's a Franco Dragon production, so it's really back at the root of Cirque du Soleil and what we're all about. It's just a beautiful, very poetic, very very intense too at moments. And the music is just amazing, and we have all these beautiful aerial acts, and it's just a really great show.
Excellent, and definitely family friendly. This
definitely,
one would appeal to children.
For sure, I would say probably 5 years and older. Just because sometimes, you know, there's blackouts and booms of lightning and things like that. And usually, but as an example, my nephew saw it when he was 3 years old, when we started in Montreal. And he was able to sit through the whole thing, and what he still remembers and talks to me about the music and one of the characters, the clown that just made him laugh, he still calls that silly clown. He was really funny. So,
aww, sweet.
So yeah. It really depends on every kid, but usually we recommend about 5 years and older.
Mm-hmm. So a good way to create memories with the family.
Absolutely, and it's good because you can watch videos on the website prior to and kind of introduce them to the characters and make them feel connected to the show. So when they come, they get really excited and they recognize things. And it does create great memories. And sometimes it's very inspiring for them to see what what's happening on stage. And maybe that's something they would want to work towards in life.
Absolutely. Yeah. Now, speaking of families, I know a lot of Cirque shows travel with a number of families and yeah. with the school. How many do you know approximately how many families are touring with?
Well, with our show Quidam, it's a bit different because, like I said, we changed the format of the show. So we are under the arenas now, and we do travel and move every single week. Ah. So it's not really, the type of touring that we do is not quite family friendly. In the big top productions, we have time to set up and have the school, we have the playground, and then it's easier and more convivial for the families to follow. We're a bit more rock and roll style, so we're going to stick around, and sometimes we'll have the families visit, but most of them don't stay with the tour because we can't provide schooling and all the good stuff that we can do for the families under the big top. So it's just a different kind of touring.
So are there a lot of family people that are in the show, and then they just
there are a few, but not that many
periodically, or it's more of a single show.
Yeah, it's more single or couples show, or people that that have been doing this for a long time and their families are used to it. Other than that, I think people with families very often will target the resident shows or the big top shows.
Right, that way they're in a town for a month or more, right?
Yeah, exactly. Usually it's about 6 weeks. Yeah, and then they have apartments, so they can cook and do everything. We live more the hotel style kind of living, so it's just it's a bit maybe a younger crowd and a crowd that's a bit more into fast pace and moving a lot. And so yeah,
absolutely. All right. So is there anything else you want to let us know about the show?
It's a great...
8 through 12.
Yeah, that's it, all the dates. And we have a different range of tickets. There's a ticket for everyone. And I know we stress the fact that it was family friendly, but it's also a great date night suggestion. So if you're single or if you have a family but find a babysitter, it's a great date night and it's good boyfriend points. Easy.
Excellent. All right. Well, thank you so much for taking the time to meet with us.
Well, thank you for coming to see us today.
And we'll look forward to seeing the show in February.
Good. Thank you.